All right, so here I am today. I'm working back on this Petit Rouge painting. And I thought I might give you an example of how I handle my brushes when I'm painting in some of this landscape and cloudscape. I've already got all this area up here finished for the most part. I haven't started on the plane yet, the finishing work on the plane, but I'm happy with my clouds, I'm happy with the sky, and I've come in here, some of these lower clouds, I want them to appear closer than the ones in the background, so I popped some big old boogers of texture on those just to help them pop out a little more from the background here and on that one too. That doesn't really show up very well on a digital file, but when you see this painting in person, those little spots of texture will really help those clouds pop out. And what I'm doing now is I'm coming down here in the lower area and then I'm trying to define this landscape a little bit. And I don't want to get too detailed. I don't want that to draw your attention down there because I don't want it to be distracting. But really what I'm doing is I'm coming in over the existing underpainting and I'm just taking some side brush and I'm brushing in a little more pigment. And I'm just kind of letting the paint grab wherever it's going to grab. And that really creates nice effects when you do that. Sometimes I'll do this with a palette knife, but in this case, kind of gotten started with my little round here. So I'm just going to continue with that. And I'm doing a lot of side brush, just lightly brushing that in. Getting some texture. I'll probably come back in a few spots and change a few things I don't like, because there will be those spots. You don't want all of this to be texture. You want some of it to be quiet, so I'll come quiet some of that down a little bit. Let's step back and look at it and see how it looks. I could use a little more dark under here. So I'm going to come in with some of my dark and just side swipe that in. Down here, down at the bottom, I like these little areas of color where the sunset's kind of hitting the ground below. I'm going to keep those, but I'm going to get a little more accent to them. Hopefully this isn't sounding like a Bob Ross video. But I'm going to come in and just touch these, the happy little landscape down here, and see what kind of effects I can get. Now, it's one thing to look at this up close while I'm painting, but I find what's really effective is to turn around and look at the thing in the mirror and see how it looks from a distance. And I see already a few spots that I want to quiet down. So I'm going to turn right back around and come back to my paints down here. And what I'm doing is I'm basically just dabbing my brush in a little bit of several different colors, just loading it up. I want to get some texture down here. I want this to look nice. I'm just kind of indicating land masses and forms down here. This really should not be highly detailed because we're not telling that story. It's not about the landscape below. This is about the airplane in its environment. And you got to keep sight of that. Got to keep track of that. What story you're trying to tell. And I'm going to keep doing that until I'm happy with this landscape. Probably take me a couple more hours on that. I'll mess with this background a little more, soften some edges, soften some of that texture where I don't want it, get my values right, and then this afternoon I'm probably going to start coming in here and playing with this airplane. Now you see, right there, I've already got some rigging indicated. I'll show you how I do that in a later video. I'm probably going to have to, now that I've painted over some of that background again, I'm going to have to come back in here and redefine some of that rigging just to make it pop out a little more. Maybe I can tackle that next week. But for the time being, let's keep working on this.